This is a loop, and 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 this, and this, and this, and this. So if these are all loops, what's a loop? A loop in a Qlik application automation processes lists of data one at a time. Lists can be a collection of strings, an array of JSON objects, or rows of data from a spreadsheet. Let's start with a basic example. Here, I've created a list variable with three items, 1, 2, and 3. Then I add a loop block from the basic menu underneath the variable. In the block configurator, a reference to the variable appears automatically. Loops iterate over list items one at a time and provide the option to manipulate the current item in the loop by adding blocks inside the loop's path. I've added an output block to print the value of the current list item in the loop. When I run this automation, you can see the output prints each item in the list on its own line, demonstrating the way the loop moves through the list. Let's move on to the next level and loop through some JSON structured data. Here I have a JSON array, and we're going to run it through a loop with an output, the same as the numbers previously. The output recognizes the JSON array items and prints them out like a table. What if I want to print only the superhero names of each character? In the output block, I can specify the property to print from each object in the list being looped by selecting the superhero name property from the data to output dialog. Running the automation again displays only the superhero names. Outputs aren't the only operations you can perform inside a loop. Let's add a condition block and have it print only the records where the name contains Tony. Another way to filter, compare, or merge lists is to use the list function blocks in the lists menu. Replacing the loop with a filter list allows you to take a list as an input and use conditions to create a new list without using the condition logic we added in the previous example. But there is a caveat for using the list function blocks. While these blocks improve automation readability, they require loading all list data into memory. If the list requires more memory than is available in the automation, then the automation will fail. The current max memory limit for an automation is 300 megabytes. If you're working with large lists, use the first method I covered using loop blocks with condition blocks to filter the list into a new list. Lists for looping don't just come from made-up JSON input. Most of the time, list data comes from applications in support of running an automation. Here's a Salesforce list accounts block, and it's configured to return the name and website of the account record. Outside of the list loop, I added a lookup item in list block. This block returns a single item from a list based on the condition you add. Just like with the filter list block and other list function blocks, use the lookup block on lists you know aren't really big. If the list really is big, here's an alternate way of doing the same thing. Inside the loop, I added a condition block that checks the current record for a match. And if it's true, then I get the account information and exit the loop. And like I said, there are loads of list blocks in many of the connectors available in Qlik Application Automation. The good news is they all loop the same way. Now you know more about the loop block and how it can help you in your automations. For more tips and tricks, how-tos, and to join the automations conversation, visit community.qlik.com. See you soon.